Welcome to the Sunday edition of Sports Frenzy Recap Show.
Recap Show? What?
Yes.
Isn't it a little early for a recap show?
It's noon.
No. Oh, I'll allow it then.
Okay. Me too.
What's up, Rose?
Not much. My head feels a little lighter. I'm a skinny.
You shave your head?
A little bit, yeah.
That's your military do going on?
I do.
Wow. It looks different.
Oh, yeah.
Does it feel good, though, for this weather?
Actually, it does feel really good.
Yeah.
So.
Of course, in your neck of the woods, you never know. It could turn off cold again.
This is true. I could have snow tomorrow.
I wasn't going to say that.
I'll say it. We could have snow. You never know. Yeah. But let's get to these picks.
The second to the last picks edition here.
It is. We have.
Yep, I should say.
Hey, it's all good.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Major League Baseball. We have the Blue Jays over the Rangers, 6-1.
We have the Pirates over the Cubs, 2-0.
The Tigers defeat the Cleveland Indians 7-5, and that was a 3-point bonus game.
We have a delay here for the Nationals. Apparently, they got rained out last night. Is that what it was?
Friday night. Yep.
Oh, Friday. Yeah. What? Yeah, they got rained out Friday night. That game is rescheduled for today, so you get a point either way, people.
That's right.
Take a point. That one.
If you're curious who wins,
go ahead, take a point for it. We don't care.
You can take a point, yeah.
It's an early edition of the show. We won't be able to tell you the score anyway, so just take a point for it. It's the next to last show. What's it going to hurt?
That's right. The Angels defeat the Red Sox 9-5.
The Cards over the Reds 9-2.
The Tampa Bay Rays over the Baltimore Orioles. 2-1.
The A's over the White Sox, 4-3.
The Diamondbacks are victorious over the Giants, 3-1.
Rogers Dodgers over the Braves, 2-1.
The Kansas City Royals defeat the Houston Astros, 4-2.
Now it's time for some arena football. Over the Voodoo, 65-56. Well, I go from deep pitch to high pitch. That was tough.
I bet. The Chicago, what a rush, defeat the Utah Blaze.
Oh, man.
67-43. Are you losing your voice?
Not losing my voice, but you know, that kind of... I got all choked up off that one.
Yeah.
All right, we have the Rattlers over the Talons, 70-21. You say, whoopin'.
Yep, apparently the Rattlers are excellent this year. The Spokane Shock defeat the Jacksonville Sharks, 76-41.
I tried to tell people that the Pittsburgh Power were powerless, but nobody wanted to hear it. But you got the Sabercats, power, 68-54.
NBA playoff action. San Antonio Spurs defeated the Miami Heat, 92-88, and that was your other 3-point bonus game.
Too bad we didn't have that clap track loaded up for this one.
Oh.
Clap, clap, clap. Woohoo, yeah! Goes first. We have the Blackhawks over the LA Kings, 3-2, and that series is now over.
Nope, that series is still going on. Boston series. Boston defeated the Pittsburgh Penguins 1-0 to close out that series. Let me double check here, but I do not think...
I was thinking this series was over, too.
Nope.
Chicago Red Sox left.
I think, oh, you're correct, actually, I think. You might be correct. Saturday. Yeah, you're right. Yep, I'm sorry. Yeah, Saturday was their last game, and the Blackhawks won Saturday 4-3 in two overtimes. So your next game will be Wednesday, and your Stanley Cup Finals is between the Chicago Blackhawks and the Boston Bruins, an original six meeting.
They said there hasn't been an original six meeting since 1979.
I could believe it. It's been a few years. Oh! Roll it!
It started off so good. Really, like, wow, he's got it going.
And then
it just off.
And then it just stopped. Yep, I lost it. Sorry.
Right.
We don't have NASCAR results because it's only 12:08 p.m. right now, and the race usually doesn't start till like 3. So.
Someone has a busy schedule today, so we have to shoot an early edition.
This guy does. So I gotta work tonight.
We'll have your NASCAR results. It'll just be when Rose sends out the footage.
Yep, I'll send it out later tonight, and I will put on there the results of NASCAR, and I'll probably
throw. Busy schedule.
What?
I said it'll be way later tonight with your busy schedule.
This is true. And I'll probably also put on there the National Twins score, too. So, yeah.
Aw, that's kind of you.
I try. It's my good deed for the day.
What a guy.
I know. Let's see. Got some news here. Dennis Rodman says LeBron James would be average if he played in the 1990s and insists James Miami Heat would be no match for his old Chicago Bulls team. Dennis Rodman says, I'm just sick and tired of people comparing James to Michael Jordan, Rodman says. It's a whole different era, man. There you go. Dennis Rodman's sick of it as much as I'm sick of it.
You know, I mean, it is hard to make comparisons like that to the players of the old days. And it was a while back, I posted this on the, I believe I posted this on the Frenzy page a while back. It was during the Olympics when the Olympic teams were playing each other. And they kept bringing up that stuff about, these guys are better today, these guys are better today. How would they play against the legends? How would they play against the legends? My favorite response to that was when they asked Larry Bird if this generation's players could beat him. And he said, his comment to that was, they probably could beat me today. I haven't played in over 20 years.
Yeah, and he's,
I loved that comment. That was great.
Stop he's right a little there. Older, too, so.
Yeah, he's a little.
We need a time machine. I would love to take LeBron James and all the great players of today back to the, you know, the 1990s and face off against, like, the Dream Team. There will only be one Dream Team.
Well, you can play him if you own, is it NBA 2K13, I believe.
Ooh.
You have an Xbox, you could get that game, bro.
I could, and I could see who would win.
They have the current Olympic team can play the old Dream Team.
Ooh.
Yes.
Now, hopefully the old Dream Team doesn't have the Daisy Duke shorts, though. That is one thing I didn't like about the 90s was those Daisy Duke shorts. Anyways, former Detroit Lion.
He didn't like them on guys.
Yes, this is true. Former Detroit. Former Detroit Lions wide receiver Titus Young has posted bond and has been released from an Orange County jail where he was being held for allegedly trying to burglarize a San Clemente home. Detroit News reports the amount of his bond was $50,000. Young's father, Richard Young, said his son started changing after sustaining a concussion early in his rookie year with the Detroit Lions in 2011. Young never appeared on the league's injury report with a concussion, although he did battle various elements in two seasons. Vincent said he wasn't aware of Young's having a concussion. Titus Young's father saying his son suffers from a mental health disorder and needs help.
You can see where this is going. That's what I'm laughing about.
Yes.
They're going to end up trying to sue the Lions or something. You can see that coming down the road.
Yep. The Lions or the NFL or something like that. And then my last thing I have, NHL news. Ralph Kruger, the head coach of the Edmonton Oilers, was fired Saturday after leading the team to a 12th place finish in the Western Conference in his lone season. The Oilers have missed playoffs 7 straight years. They were 19-22-7 in the lockout shortened season.
For next year, we're going to have more sound bites for our show. Because right there would be a perfect spot for, like, when somebody gets fired, we can put in, like, the Vince McMahon voice track of that.
I could. I actually have already started working on creating sound bites for next year. Pull up the folder here. I actually have added a few sound bites, just if anyone's curious. We have the... This will be good for
trivia.
Yeah. And I might actually start creating different intros for all of our categories. We have the NASCAR intro, and I have also worked on an NFL intro, which I'm very proud of, and I think I might start working on an NHL one, so... So, yes, I...
Intros for all our different sports, that's a good idea.
I'm going to be working very hard here. I'll have to see if Arena Football has an intro.
Tell you what, boy, we've got a budget increase for 4.0 coming up.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be busy this summer creating intros, creating sound bites, all
That's
sorts
perfect.
Of good
Work
stuff.
Work in progress, people. You're going to love it.
But that's all I have. What do you got, Tim?
I got nothing.
You got nothing.
Not too early in the sense that you know, I'm not up or anything. It's just too early for me to have any info, so I'm done. That's it. It's over.
Hey, that's cool.
We're out of here.
Cool.
We got an afternoon.
That's right, we do.
Got things to do, too. You don't want to hear us. It's summertime, man.
It is. Well, we got one more week of Frenzy, don't we?
Yeah, the final week of Frenzy coming up next week.
Oh, man.
Yes. And then the final recap show that Monday. So, it's gonna be a good one.
It will. It will indeed. So.
To try and make it special, Rose.
Oh, I'll try. I'm already got my brain's already working overtime for it. So I believe that's gonna be another Thursday night edition, isn't it? Or
all our guests, you know, we'll have to have Bad Axe make an appearance. And,
sure. The gnome. The dancing robot, Superman.
Yeah, we gotta have a good send off for 3.0.
That's right.
We kind of lead off into 4.0. So.
Well, we do have Superman in the screen right now. Actually, I see he's sitting up by your shoulder there, Tim. Dummy Tim, anyways. And if you are curious, yes, Tim did win the title belt this week by one point.
Yeah. 8 season comeback for this champ.
Oh yeah.
On that note, everybody, have a great rest of your weekend. We will see you again very soon for the final edition of Sportsy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I am the coach.
I'm Jamie.
And if you're not not down with that.
We got two words for you. Break it down!
You can tell me.